All right.
Are you ready?
Good to go.
Here they come.
All right, I'm just going to give a moment for everyone to get connected to audio. We appreciate you joining us this afternoon. So to be respectful of everyone's time, I'm going to go ahead and get us started. Good afternoon again. Once again, my name is Heather Venice. I'm the principal here at Riverside Prep Elementary. I would like to welcome you to our 2021-2022 school year, the kindergarten roundup to get us started and kicked off for the school year. Before we hear some information directly from our kindergarten teachers, I want to turn the time over to my administrative team.
All right, I just want to introduce myself. I'm Sean Redmond. I'm one of the assistant principals here at the elementary, and we're really happy to have y'all here at Kinder Roundup.
Definitely. And I am Adrienne Kilzer. I'm the other assistant principal here at Riverside Prep Elementary School. Welcome. We're so excited to have you. We're sad we can't have it on campus this year, but that's okay. We'll still get you all the information you need today. Our Kinder team has worked really hard on making a video to introduce themselves and how our Kinder program works. So we're going to go ahead and kick that off. It is rather lengthy, but there's lots of good information in there. So if you have any questions, please jot them down. And at the end of the video, we'll take any questions that anyone has and make sure that we can answer them the best that we can. So let me share my screen here and we'll get going.
I'll meet you at the top of the coconut tree. We said D to EFG. I'll beat you to the top of the coconut tree. Chicka chicka boom, will there be enough? Here comes H up the coconut tree. And I and J and tag along K, all on their way up the coconut tree. Chicka chicka boom, will there be enough? Look who's coming, it's L and N O P, and U R S T U V, still more W than X Y Z.
Hi, and welcome to Riverside Prep's Transitional Kindergarten Program. Transitional Kindergarten is the program for students between the ages of 4 and 5. And is geared towards bridging the gap between preschool and kindergarten. TK provides younger students with the opportunity to develop fundamental skills that are needed for success in school, and it creates a firm foundation for future learning. So what will your student be learning? Well, here at Riverside Prep, we put a heavy emphasis on developing social and communication skills through a curriculum that allows students to build confidence in areas such as math, literacy, and language development. Our comprehensive curriculum allows students to learn about their emotions, how to make good choices, how to work and play well with others, by interacting with the learning materials as well as the other students. So throughout the year, students will work both independently and cooperatively to learn how to develop and maintain a positive sense of self, how to make friends and resolve conflicts. They'll learn how to identify their emotions and control their impulses, and they'll learn how to focus their attention so that they can follow classroom and school rules. Throughout the year, we use our ELA curriculum to help students grow in their ability to communicate with others, express their ideas, and increase their reasoning skills. Students will have the opportunity to interact with literature through discussions and activities. They'll learn how to recognize all of the letters in the alphabet. They learn their letter sounds, and they begin to represent their thoughts and ideas through writing and dictation and pictures. This is also incorporated into our social studies curriculum, where students will be learning about themselves, their families, and their local communities. Transitional kindergarten also provides students with the opportunity to develop their mathematical reasoning skills, which is very important when transitioning into kindergarten. So during the year, students get to practice counting, we practice pattern recognition, one-to-one correspondence, sorting and classifying objects, comparing groups of objects, and they'll learn how to identify and construct different shapes. In science, students will take those reasoning skills and they will learn how to ask questions, make observations and predictions. They'll record the information, and we do a lot of really fun science experiments. The best part of TK is that it is very interactive and we have a lot of fun. So I hope to see you next school year. Bye.
Good afternoon. Welcome to Kindergarten Roundup. My name is Mrs. Ackerman and I'm one of the kindergarten teachers here at Riverside Prep Elementary School. I'm going to talk to you about our curriculum that we use in our classroom. For English language arts, we use McGraw-Hill Wonders, and for phonemic awareness, we use Hegarty, which consists of different learning modalities for our students. For math, we use Embark. And what's really nice about Embark and McGraw-Hill is we have online resources for independent practice, so students can practice at home or in their classroom. Students will be receiving a device, so teachers will be asking their students to bring their device once or twice a week, and we will inform parents when it's time to put in their backpacks to bring for the next day. With Embark, we have Zurn, which is aligned with the math curriculum. And that's another online resource that students can use for independent practice. For our SEL, which is also known as social and emotional learning, we use Lion's Quest. And something new that we are adopting next year is a new science curriculum, which is by Discovery Ed. Also, as a team in kindergarten, we collaborate as a team, and as a team, we gather a bunch of online resources that we share with each other to make sure students receive materials that would fit their learning needs. If you have any further questions about the curriculum, please go ahead and send them to one of us. Have a good day.
Hello, my name is Melissa Tumanian, and I am a kindergarten teacher here at Riverside Prep, and I am happy to talk to you today about parent expectations. What is expected from all parents of our students here will be attending kindergarten next year? So first and foremost, we ask that all parents are reachable and that they have some form and method of communication. So normally we use a platform. It usually is Blooms, and it's kind of like an app that we ask that you download on your phone, or you can use it on your computer. And it looks like it's a Facebook, but it's only for the class. So nobody else outside of the class sees it. We do a lot of communication on those platforms that we use for the classroom. We post a lot of photos, and we also post notices. We send flyers home. If you ask to be communicated with in a different way, for example, text or email, we can accommodate you as well. But we do have to have some kind of updated form of way to communicate with you every day. Also, in case there's a transportation change, or if there is something we need to tell you about your child or your child's work, or something that we need to urgently get a message to you right away, we need to be able to get a hold of you. So please, please, more than one method of communication would be ideal. That would be great. We ask that you read the notices and the flyers. We will be putting things in your child's backpack. It will be work, completed work. It will be progress reports, report cards, letters, curriculum notices. I put things in children's backpack about what we're learning for science, what we're learning for math and ELA. So we ask that you please look in your child's backpack and see what they have on a daily basis so that you're not missing any information whatsoever. We also ask that when they bring their device to school next year, it won't be every day, but when they do, to make sure that their devices are charged and ready to go. Occasionally, we use the devices to do online learning games, and we collaborate on the devices. We use them as for reading and also for writing and for assessments and quizzes and testing. So they will be learning how to use their device, whether it is an iPad or a Chromebook. Whatever it is, please make sure that it is charged. And when you send it in with your child, make sure that you send the charging cord with it, just in case it loses a charge during the day or it's not properly charged. We are able to plug that into the classroom for them. If this is a parent choice school, so we ask that you are invested and that you become involved in your child's learning. We here on the kindergarten team, we feel that it is a collaborative effort with the parents to teach your child. So we like to stay in touch about what your child is learning, what we're teaching them, and the different strategies that we can use so that they can learn and succeed and make sure that they're meeting benchmark and meeting the standards so that they can move on to first grade. So we like to work together with you. We want to make sure you're well informed. And we want you to make sure you are not shy about asking us questions and communicating with us your needs and what your expectations are from us. We expect that there is support at home, that you do have pencils and access to basic materials so that they can practice if they do need to practice. But when they are in the classroom, they will be getting supplies. So there is no need for you to send any supplies with your child to school. We will have everything for them. We also ask that you provide them, we suggest you provide them with a standard sized backpack. This is so that when we give flyers, notices, completed work to take home, that it is secure and zipped up in the backpack. Children will also be getting meals, and when they get meals, they'll have to zip it up in their backpack. And if they're not provided with one and they're carrying a lot of papers around and a lot of food and different kinds of materials and objects, their science projects that they're going to be taking home, things are going to be flying in the wind and they're going to be spilling all over the place. And then once it's on the bus, it'll get lost. So we do suggest, it's not required that you provide them with a backpack, but we think it's a really good idea that you do that. We have an honor code here. It's hardworking. H is for hardworking, O is for organized, N is for noble, O is for outstanding, and R is for respectful. We ask that you're consistent with the kindergarten teachers here in pursuing the honor code and enforcing it and making sure, we make sure that we teach those values to our students, and we hope that you are consistent with teaching those values at home as well. We want to make sure that all of our students are Silver Knights, and we refer to that term often when we're talking about behavior and discipline and how important it is to be a Silver Knight when you're at Riverside Prep. And we hope that this will instill the value of the honor code in our students, and it will carry over to each grade that they go to. Attendance is a big deal. We ask that you make sure that your child is, if you're dropping them off at school, that they're dropped off on time, that you adhere to our attendance policy. And the attendance policy can be found online. If you have further questions about that, you can ask us at a later time. Children will come to school and have breakfast. They will attend their learning classes throughout the day with us, the teacher, with their teacher. They will have access to specials classes that they will be doing. And then at the end of the day, we ask that you provide us, if there are any changes in transportation, provide us with that update at least by 2:30 at the end of the day, so that we have adequate time to accommodate the transportation change. If there are any questions about that as well, you can always call the transportation office, or you can call the main office and talk to administration. So that's about it. We are a very close-knit team here, and we're excited to see your child start at Riverside Prep. Kindergarten is a wonderful experience, whether your child has already been in school or has had no schooling whatsoever. We guarantee that they will have a good experience here in kindergarten. We will be teaching them with a team approach. We will be collaborating with you as a team as well. So don't hesitate to reach out and ask any questions. And we hope to see you soon. So thank you very much.
Hello, future Silver Knight kindergartners. My name is Mrs. Murkett, and I teach kindergarten here at Riverside Prep. We are putting together a video to let you know a little bit about what you can expect when you go to school here. The first thing we're going to talk about a little bit is manners. Yes, we like our students to say please and thank you, I'm sorry, you're welcome. These kinds of nice words here at Riverside Prep, kind words are very important. Also, part of our expectations are that you will one right next door that you can use. And so when you need to go potty, you will give your teacher the signal and you'll go use the potty. And when you're in the bathroom, you have to remember that we have to keep our bathrooms clean and we have to take care of our bathrooms. Also, because the bathroom is so close to our classrooms, you have to use a quiet voice. Never play in the bathroom. I don't think any of you would, but sometimes kids do. So don't play in the bathroom, just use the potty, wash and dry your hands, and get right back to class as quickly as you can. Now, another thing we expect you to be able to do is to follow directions. That means you will have your listening ears on and they'll be turned up, and you will listen to your teacher and follow directions. When she asks you to sit down, when she asks you to write something, when she asks you to line up a certain way. Yeah, that's what following directions means. For our students, we would like each of you to bring a regular sized backpack to class every day. And you will be taking home your good work to show your parents, to show your grandparents, anybody who wants to see your good work. You'll be taking that home in your backpack every day so that they can look at it and see how much you're learning here. Also, next year, we have a grant from the government again that all students will be given free lunch. So that will be available to everybody. And if you don't want a school lunch, that's okay too, but you will need to bring your own food from home. And you can always, if there's something that looks good to you, like say you brought a sandwich but you want some milk, you could get a milk from school. The backpacks reminds me of another topic. We're going to talk about devices. You are each going to be given a device, either an iPad or a Chromebook, and you will need to bring it to school every day and take it home every day. Now, when you get a device, It's your responsibility to take care of it. You got to make sure that you don't leave it on the floor because someone could step on it. Got to make sure that your hands are clean when you use it so it doesn't get gunked up. You will be responsible for taking care of your device and bringing it to school and back every day in your backpack. When you come to class, each student has a box about that big, and it will have your supplies in it. It will have crayons for you, pencils, a whiteboard with a whiteboard marker and eraser, math manipulatives, all kinds of things for you to use to learn while you're in kindergarten, to learn with while you're in kindergarten. Now, here at Riverside Prep, we do have a dress code. This year, part of that dress code has been wearing a mask every day, all day. We expect that that will be an expectation when you come to kindergarten in the fall as well. So just be prepared, keep your mask on at all times, except when you are eating or drinking. You know, I thought that was gonna be a problem with kindergartners and hard for kindergartners. It turns out I'm wrong. Kindergartners are great at keeping their masks on and remembering to put them on when they're done eating. So yeah, it's not so bad. It really isn't. Back to the dress code. We have a rule for students, no sandals, no flip-flops, no open-toed shoes. So you're gonna want to wear a nice quality closed-toed shoes to keep your feet safe. Also, no short shorts. Yeah, they have to be at least about mid-thigh, a few inches above your knee. Yeah, we expect that, and no short tops either. So if you raise your hands, both hands, because we do that a lot in class, the shirt needs to be long enough that even when your hands are raised, your belly doesn't show. Also, you can buy and get a Riverside Prep shirt, or you can wear a college shirt. But other than that, we're not supposed to wear like professional basketball team shirts or other sports shirts. Yeah, we're supposed to keep it simple here when we're dressing. We will expect you to be able to communicate with your teacher. Do you know what that means? Communicate, that's a big word. That means you need to tell your teacher when you need something and your teacher needs to listen. So if you have a bathroom emergency and you cannot wait, you need to be able to tell your teacher that and your teacher will let you go use the bathroom. If you don't understand what the teacher's doing, it's not making sense, you need to raise your hand and tell the teacher. If you are trying your best to make a new letter, to write a new letter, and you're not sure how to do it, you need to be able to raise your hand and ask the teacher to help you learn to make that new letter. So don't be shy. Just your teacher, whoever you get, will love you and they will help you. Let's see. Oh, it's also very important, boys and girls, that you never leave the room without telling your teacher. Your teacher's number one job at this school, you might be thinking that it is to teach you to read and write and count. Number one job, we have to keep you safe. We cannot keep you safe if you just leave the room. So that's not allowed. You have to stay in the classroom unless you need to use the bathroom. And then you really need to tell your teacher that you need to use the bathroom. You can't just walk out, okay? Will you do that? Will you stay inside the classroom and stay safe with your teacher? Yes, awesome. All right, we are gonna talk Our next topic is, actually, I'm done with the topics, but I just want to say, my name is Mrs. Burkett. I am so excited to meet you and have you in my class. We have so many fun activities planned, so many adventures. It will be a great year. Bye.
Hi, everyone. My name is Alyssa Taylor, and I am a kindergarten teacher here at Riverside Prep. I'm going to be talking to you just a little bit more about some of the student expectations. So the first one has to do with our discipline policy. In the classroom as teachers, you know, we try to correct any behaviors we see, even if it's something small, just so that when they move on to the next grade, they're prepared. If for some reason we have a problem correcting the behavior, or we run into a hiccup, we will contact you. Usually if we have an issue, we'll contact you just to be on the safe side to make you aware and keep the communication open. If that behavior isn't corrected though, unfortunately, we will contact administration to get involved and, you know, support you, support us, and support the child in our classroom. Before you come to kindergarten, your students will need to know a few things. A lot of them are very basic and simple things like writing their first name. Last names aren't necessary. If they know how, that would be great, but it's not required. They should be able to hold a pencil correctly. So they shouldn't be holding it with their fist at all. And I know that's kind of tricky sometimes. So just try to work on that with them. They should know their alphabet and recognize some of the letters if shown them out of order. They should be able to count to 10 without help. And they should be able to tie their own shoes. If that is an issue though, just, you know, send shoes with Velcro, send slip-ons or shoes with elastics. Those are all great options for that. I also want to talk a little bit about our Silver Knights of Honor Code. At our school, we have an honor code, and students are expected to follow this honor code throughout the school day, whether they're with us, during specials, during buses, whatever the situation may be. They're expected to be honest, kind, and respectful to all of the people they encounter on campus. So students, staff members, other teachers, proctors, all of those kinds of things. So our honor code, the H in our honor code stands for hardworking. So this just means, you know, they're on task, they're turning in their work. The first O stands for outstanding. And this means, you know, they're just following classroom rules, school rules, basic things we do throughout our day. The N stands for noble. And this means that, you know, they're just responsible. And again, that means in our class, outside of our class, in the bathroom, on the bus, things like that. The second O stands for organized. And this means they're just completing their assignments the best that they can. Especially at the beginning of the year, we know this is challenging for a lot of them. So we kind of try to transition them into it. We don't expect a lot at the beginning because they're still getting used to it. And the day can be long with our extended schedule. And the R stands for respectful. This just means they're respectful, as the other rules explained. For following our honor code, we give out purple tickets is what the kids call them, but they're really pretty pink. And these tickets they get for following our honor code, they look like this and they have our mascot, our Silver Knight of Honor on there. And students get those, they get entered into a drawing in the office and they get prizes pulled every Friday. We are so looking forward to having your students here for kindergarten with us, and we can't wait to meet all of you.
Hi, my name is Mrs. CW, and I am one of the kindergarten teachers. I am going to be talking to you today about the supplies that are going to be needed for your students when they come to kindergarten. The great news is that all of their classroom supplies will be provided for them. So they will not have to bring pencils or erasers, crayons, colored pencils, paper, anything that they're going to need to complete their work in class will be provided by the school. Some things that you can think about getting for your students that will be helpful will be a full-size backpack. That way they have a way to transport things that they're bringing from home or taking home from school. Also, you could pack them an extra change of clothes that can stay in their backpacks. That way, if there are any accidents at school, they have something to change into that they can fit and they are familiar with. And then students are provided lunches at school, but if your student would like to bring a lunch from home, they can do so as well.
For transportation, parents have the option to use their own source of transportation or choose our school's bus service. Bus transportation is offered to all Riverside Prep students at no cost. Bus routes, as well as drop-off and pickup times, are in our district website. The routes are all throughout the high desert for your convenience. All kinder students will be marked with a transportation number or a symbol on the top of their hand for the first 2 weeks of school. As a kinder team, we will do this to help other school staff know where the students should be for dismissal. Students will be guided by the kinder teachers to their assigned bus, the parent pickup line, or the walker's gate. The walker's option is only available for Oro Grande students. Students taking the bus must follow all school rules and the bus rules. Now, all parents will receive free transportation cards at the beginning of the school year. Any person picking up the student is required to show that transportation card with the student's name on it. For the safety of the student, we will not release the student without the transportation card. If students are not picked up either from school or the bus stop, they will be taken to the school's office. Parents will be contacted and or any other person listed in the emergency list. Please make sure your information stays current at all times. The following video will explain the parent pickup process.
So some of you might be wondering what goes on in TK and in kindergarten during an extended day. We don't take any naps, surprisingly. Students are always working, their brains and ears are always on. And so we have provided you with a little overview of our schedule and how it would look during the day. So we have here usually breakfast in our morning meeting, where during our morning meeting, students are able to collaborate with their classmates, with their teacher, have a little bit of fun before we actually put those thinking caps on and turn on the listening ears for their teacher. After our morning meeting and breakfast, we get into our McGraw-Hill and Wonders curriculum for English Language Arts. We may practice some writing, our sight words, our numbers, our letters, things like that. Do a read aloud, talk about it. After our morning ELA and writing time, we have lunch and recess. When we come in from recess, we normally put on some quiet music, have the students put their heads down, get a drink of water. It takes usually about 3 to 5 minutes to get them to calm down from lunch and recess. After our cool down, we get into math, where we do our Embark videos and also use our manipulatives, or we get right into calendar. And calendar is something really special that we use in kindergarten because it really hits a lot of our Common Core state standards that students need to know by the end of kindergarten. After our math time, we go back to ELA and we go into our closed reading books or our practice books. And now these are the books where students are able to write in, and we do it as a whole class. And it usually is based off of maybe the read aloud we did the morning, earlier in the morning, and based off the videos that we watched for ELA from McGraw-Hill and things like that. After that block of ELA time, we get to have specials. And during specials, students get to go to another classroom, whether it's music, PE, or library time. And during that time, of course, they might be singing, PE, they're exercising, and library, this is something new that we are so excited to open this year and have students get to possibly check out books and all that good stuff. After we come back from specials, we do complete our language arts math from the morning that we didn't get to finish, or we do a possible review of reading or blending our CVC words or writing. After we complete all three of these, we get into our nutritional snack and recess time. Nutritional snack, again, if you are not able to provide a snack, we have snacks in our classroom that we can provide for students that forgot theirs or wasn't able to pack one. Then we go outside for a little bit of recess. And after our recess, again, we do our heads down, cool down, and a water break. Again, 3 to 5 minutes is about the time that we play our quiet music, calm us down, and then we get back to work. Usually after nutritional snack and recess, we will get into science, social studies, art, or centers. And 2 days out of the week, many of us teachers do centers at the end of the day. I know there's some teachers who might do it a little bit more often. Many of us do it on average about 2 times a week. And during the center's time, this is where we do our reading intervention groups, we do our math intervention groups, we challenge our students who need to be challenged more, we do one-on-ones or small groups, all of those things to get extra help for students who need more support or who want to be challenged more. After that, we pack up, we sing some songs, do our afternoon meetings, what they learned for the day, what are they going to say when they get home to mom and dad or grandma and grandpa, and then we go ahead and do our dismissal. Now during dismissal, again, we do walk our students in kindergarten and TK to their buses and to parent pickup or walkers. It's wherever students are supposed to be. We have teachers designated in every area to make sure students are getting to the appropriate place to go home.
I'm not nervous, I'm not scared. I feel the energy in the air. And I'm ready, I feel so cool. And I bet you feel it too. Well, my heart skips, skips a beat. And I don't care what you think. I take my chance on breaking it down.
That concludes our Kinder Roundup video that was made by our wonderful Kinder team.
Yeah, here. Before we end our time here with you today, we just wanted to let you know we have some important information that we will be sending out to you via School Messenger. So with that email that you've provided with to us and that you received the flyer and information for this meeting, we will also send all of those important links for enrollment, different documents that you need to verify that you filled out or submitted. And if you have any questions, do please feel free to reach out to us at any time. In addition, we will have the recording of this webinar made available to you as well. So we will post that information on our website. So at this time, I want to go ahead and again, thank you for being here. Thank you for joining us today. And we look forward to seeing and meeting all of you next school year. If you have any specific questions that you would like us to answer, if you want to stay behind or put those in the chat, we definitely want to answer those before you leave. If you are all good and you have all of your information, we will see you very shortly, but do feel free to reach out to any one of us with questions.
What is the start and end times of a school day?
I know we are still looking for some feedback from our district for next school year. So as soon as we have that information for our start and end times, we will get that out to you. So we should have some proposed times and some ideas for schedules for next year very soon.
If an enrollment packet has already been submitted, when do we start to receive acceptance information?
You are in. If you are here, you are in. The only thing that you need to do at this point is take a look at that email that we are going to be sending out to you shortly and make sure that you will have that you have all of the information that's in those links. So we're looking for things like updated vaccination records, the oral health exam form, the physical form. So there'll be a list of links that you can go through just to verify that you've submitted all of that paperwork.
Will parents be allowed on site for the first day of school?
That is a great question. I don't have an answer for that quite yet. With the way everything is looking with our current case rates, we are looking at being able to change some of our protocol on campus, but we will not have an answer for that, unfortunately, until closer to the school year, because obviously we can't control how things are looking with our protocol and procedures. And so we will update you as we can. And as we get closer to the first day of school, we will have a final decision on that. Mm-hmm. And then, go ahead.
I was going to read the next one. Is there going to be any in-person orientation for TK?
Just what we shared today. I don't know if you were here when we first started the video. There is a section on the video that applies just to TK as well. So that would be in a lot of the other information with TK and kinder is shared. So this is intended for both TK and kindergarten parents.
Right. And traditionally we do an orientation at the beginning of the school year, the week before school starts. Depending on what our guidelines and regulations are at the time, we'll determine whether or not it'll be in person. Or this past year, we did like a little Zoom introduction with the kids' teachers. So just depending on where we're at come the beginning of a school year, we'll kind of determine that a little bit more. Start date. We usually start the very first Monday in August. I'm not sure exactly which Monday that is this next year. I don't have it off the top of my head, but I do know that that's an always thing for us is the first Monday in August.
Yes, I believe it is that very first Monday. Let me take a look. I know that the updated calendar is on our website. So if you haven't been on our website, it's orogrand.net. If you go on there, we have our full transportation lists. We have our school calendars. There are links to all the different departments that you may need, links to enrollment if you need documents from there. So we will also include a link to the transportation and the calendar as well, so that you have that information and the direct link to that.
It looks like August 2nd is the first Monday in August, so that's probably our start date for this next school year. I'm almost positive. And then where is the bus stop location for Barstow residents? Is it still L Street? I believe it is. All of our transportation stuff is listed on the website. So if you go to riversideprep.net, you can go to departments and there's a transportation department. It has a list of all the bus stops because I think there might be more than one out in Barstow. So you can check and see which one is closest for you and most convenient. Are we allowed to email or fax in the packet? Is there already a waiting list?
You are definitely allowed to email or fax in the packet. We definitely can get you that information. And there, anybody who submits their information rather, will be added to the list. Right now, we do still have spaces for enrollment. So if you get that information into us, we should have no problem getting you set for next year. And then I had another question above that. Did we answer the student teacher ratio? So currently we are scheduled to have 6 TK and kindergarten classes total. Our capacity student to teacher ratio, we were just talking about this the other day, 24 is what we shoot for.
Yes, that's what we shoot for. Sometimes it can get up to 26, between 24 and 26 per class. Are all classes self-contained or will the students go to different teachers or classes for subjects? So yeah, they're all self-contained in our TK and kinder section. They do go to a different teacher though for their specials rotation. So for their library or PE or music, we have certificated credentialed teachers, music teachers, library teachers, and PE teachers. So they will go to those teachers for their specials activity. Other than that, for the most part, they stay in their classes. Every now and then they'll get together and do projects together and things like that. But that all depends on protocols when the time comes.
Yeah, in the past, we've done a lot of rotations with different teachers and classrooms, and teachers will share students or they'll go to different groups and rotate through. And as long as our guidelines are allowing us to do that, we would definitely like to continue that for next year. All right. Any other questions before we end our session here today?
The parent platform encourages constant communication. Absolutely. Our kinder team is really good at posting amazing information on there. They're very good at communicating any upcoming events or different transportation things. So say that you're out and about and you have to come pick up your student for the day, you can message them on there. They're really good at making sure that they communicate really well with parents.
Right.
So
that's
definitely a good thing.
That's very true. And then parent-teacher meetings, they can really be as often as they need to be. Mm-hmm. We have them scheduled throughout the year to occur in the first and the third quarters. So very first quarter, we want you to meet and talk about student progress. The third quarter one is going to be more of a check-in before the end of the school year. But if more are needed, they absolutely can be scheduled at any time.
Yes, usually happens right before October break and right before spring break. Those are our two formal ones, but you're welcome to meet with your teacher anytime that you need to. All right.
Great. Thank you guys for coming. Again, if you have any questions, please do feel free to reach out to us in the front office. You will be getting that email here shortly with all of that information, which is hopefully going to be very helpful for you as we move forward, but we're here to assist and answer any of your questions before we start next year. Mm-hmm. All right. Thank you, everyone. Have a great night and a great weekend.